welcome to this week's edition of Hawk Talk. My name is Parker Robinson, and I'm joined by Nathaniel Easton. We'll be covering the Diamond Sports this week, baseball, softball, as they start their seasons at home. Some exciting games played and some exciting games coming up. So without further ado, let's just hop right into it with Coach Watson. You know, we'll talk about it a little later with one of your players, but you opened the season at U.S. Bank Field, the home of the Minnesota Vikings. What was that experience like walking into a pro stadium like that?
Well, it's nice. You know, we've played at the Metrodome back when that was still up. I'm a Packers fan, so the whole Vikings thing.
He's a Vikings fan, which is why he will continue to bring up this game that happened months ago.
But, you know, it's a great experience for the players. I mean, that's part of my job, you know, as their coach, is to allow them to experience things like this. And playing in a big league stadium, or a big football stadium, I guess, you know, was great. And then being able to watch the Gophers and Hawaii play, you know, was good. Allow our guys to just kind of relax a little bit and watch some baseball before we got into it, kind of, you know, let the nerves kind of settle down a little bit. So, and it was good. Obviously, would have liked to walk away with a better record out of there, but, you know, it's that's baseball, and sometimes you win, sometimes you don't.
Yeah, and another one of those experiences you guys got to enjoy as a team was going down to Arizona and playing a few games down there, getting into the warm weather, same as we did on the golf team. You know, kind of add what that get some play in early in the season before coming back.
Yeah, you know, it was good to be able to play at U.S. Bank prior to us going down there, just, you know, kind of get the feet wet a little bit. You know, then going down to Arizona, you know, it was quite a bit of a climate change. I think it averaged about 89 degrees while we were down there, so a little bit different. You know, the guys played well. You know, few games, we came back 7-3. There's two games that I feel that we should have won. You know, we just didn't play very good baseball, and that's going to happen. But, you know, I felt that out of the teams that we played down there, there was only one team that was better than us. That was Westmont. You know, and that's just, it's a year-to-year thing. Sometimes, you know, you feel your team is a little bit better than others. You know, nothing against those other schools. But, you know, came back 7-3, which was our goal going down there, is to come back 10-10 overall. And, you know, we did, you know, and the last few games, you know, we had to win to get to that 7-3 record. So, you know, I was very proud of the guys about being able to fight through. You know, we had to come back from being down late in games. And, you know, Jacob Cush had a walk-off two-run home run in the top of the or the bottom of the 10th, you know, against, I believe it was Marion out of Wisconsin. You know, one of the games that we didn't play very well, but, you know, but they found a way to come out with a victory. So that was very encouraging to see.
Speaking of finding ways to come out with wins, the presentation weekend, 2 weekends ago, opened up conference play. Lots of close games, but you guys came out unscathed, 4-0 start to conference. So just touch on some of the ups and downs of that weekend.
There were a lot of ups and downs. you know, that's another weekend where I didn't feel we played our best baseball, you know, what we're capable of playing, you know. But, you know, one thing I've learned over the years is you never apologize for a win, you know. And we walked away with 4, and being able to start the conference season 4-0, you know, was huge. You know, Sean Getchell, who'll be on later, ended up with 2 saves and a victory. Should have been 3 saves, miscue on a fly ball with 2 outs in the last inning, extended the game, and we came back and won that, so we got the victory. But, you know, it was kind of tough conditions. Wind was blowing in a little bit. You know, we didn't really swing the bat very well. Pitchers actually did very good. You know, we struggled a little bit defensively, but our pitchers really competed on the mound and gave us a good shot to either stay in the game or keep a lead or finish the game, getting us the victory.
Yeah, and then coming off that, you get to come back home, play in the newly renovated Astoria Field out there on the south side of Dickinson, and picked up a couple more wins with the split against Jamestown. What was that weekend like for the team?
You know, that was, I had to look back in the archives. It was the first time since 2012 that we've at least split with Jamestown in a series. And I believe that was my second year here, so it's been a while. You know, Jamestown, very good, you know, very well coached, you know,
deep roster,
private school. But, you know, last year they won 50 games, you know, and for us to be able to come out and split, you know, was nice. Do I feel that game three got away from us? Yes, absolutely. You know, but not losing a series, you know, is key, especially early in the conference season, you know, being able to split, because Jamestown has to play Bellevue this year, you know, and Bellevue is very good as well. So being able to stay, you know, right up there with the pack, you know, coming into, you know, a big weekend this weekend. But, you know, overall last weekend, you know, we scratched out a couple wins. You know, that Jamestown put up some runs late in the second game. You know, Ryan Absher threw a great game. Kind of walked the, we're up 4-0, and he walked the first three guys of the ninth inning. Then we had to bring Sean in, who got the save. But, you know, it was, Coach Watson was a little uneasy, I guess you could say.
Really?
Believe it or not, yep. But, you know, the guys, they're playing well. And, you know, if we can continue this going into this weekend, you know, is going to be key.
The 1-0 way to close out, first off, I don't know how many NAIA series end in a 1-0 game. I don't know how many college baseball series end in a 1-0 game. That's kind of an oddity of sorts for college baseball. But that was the first 1-0 Dickinson shutout win since the same date, 2013, against Mary. So also in the archives.
Sure.
But just touch on that performance by a young man who's going to join us and how he's kind of turned into a utility arm.
Yeah, you know, Sean, he's kind of the jack of all trades pitching-wise. He's not very good with a bat. But, you know, he's been a battle. He's been a horse for us. And, you know, and that's coming in a tight game on Tuesday, or I'm sorry, on game two, and, you know, finding a way to get the save and the victory, you know, in game two. And then, you know, coming back and, you know, in that first inning, a lot of people don't know, but he had bases loaded with no outs. And which, getting away out of that inning with zero runs, I mean, doesn't happen very often. And, you know, he actually threw a good pitch. It was down in the zone, came right back to him. You know, so we got the 1-2-3 double play, and then I believe the next batter grounded out to the shortstop. So, you know, right there, you know, showed that, you know, he's a competitor. And, yes, that was early in the game. If they would have scored one, who knows what would have happened. But, you know, he battled out of some jams. You know, our defense played really good that game as well. But, you know, Sean, he threw strikes. I think he walked 4 guys in 7 innings. That's going to happen. But what you do after those walks and you can allow your defense to work is you know, is key, you know. And, you know, Jamestown had some very good arms, you know, and that's – we, I think both of us had 4 hits in that game. You know, Jacob Cush came up with a big RBI single, you know, that ended up being the game winner. You know, I think it was the 4th or 5th inning. But, you know, it's we've played quite a few of those close games. And, you know, for the most part, we're walking away with the victory. You know, but, you know, my hat's off to Sean for always, and he wants the ball. He's waiting for me to, you know, to call his name, you know, which from a coaching standpoint, that's what you want. You want players that, coach, give me the ball, let me go to work.
He's gotten the call quite a bit from you, and I think he will continue. But give us, first off, the schedule change, reiterate that, and then and what to look forward to against Valley City.
Well, as of right now, our Sunday series is now being moved to Friday, Saturday. There is a high school game Friday night, so we will be starting at 11 o'clock on Friday with a doubleheader. And then Saturday, we will start at noon, a doubleheader against Valley.
We'll talk about the bats next time you join us, because we've got two guys currently leading the conference in batting average. But hopefully they get hot this weekend, stay hot this weekend, I should say. Good luck against Valley City, Coach.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Yep. Thanks, Coach. We'll be back talking a little softball.
Life is full of many successes, achievements, stages. Every year we grow, things change, and pretty soon we realize we want and need to do more. When you're ready for that next step, Dickinson State University will get you there. Find out how at dsublue.com.
Welcome back to Hawk Talk. We're joined by another new face on the program for the spring season, and it's Coach Fleury. Just kind of touch on, you know, going down to Arizona and starting off your season in some warm weather.
Well, you know, we started our season, I know you talked to Brianna Grayson about it a little bit, in Aberdeen in the Dome, in kind of a different situation. You know, you're playing on turf, something you're not used to. You have a dome over your head, a fly ball, you know, if it touches the dome, you can play it live, or if it drops, it's a foul ball. So a couple of different rules and things, you know, and we started down there, you know, and we saw our struggles. We struggled early and we struggled often. And the thing with the softball season is such a short season, so the opportunity to get better maybe is limited, and you got, you know, months to get better and prepare. So, you know, we went down there. We played some early conference games, finished, you know, the six games in conference, 3-3. You know, yes or no, happy or mad, what do you take from it? And then we went down to Arizona, you know, and we played 14 games. Probably, you know, not our best showing that we've had in a long time. We had some kids go down with some heat stroke, put some different kids in some different situations. So, you know, it's we took a lot from it, a lot of things that we need to get better with. But, you know, last weekend we were able to start conference season at home. It was great to be at home. We had 2 weeks off to kind of work on those things that we needed to work on. And, you know, all we can ask from the kids is to get better every day.
We talked about splitting. Well, you didn't mention exactly splitting. You went 3-3 in Aberdeen and start with two splits against Jamestown. How big of a kind of positive is it when you lose that first game and find a way to not get swept, you know, to keep your head where you can still make a run at the conference and still have something to gain traction with?
You know, the thing with our conference this year is everybody's going to beat up everybody. Mm-hmm. If you look at who played who and when we played, obviously when you're playing conference games in February, it's very tough, you know, and it can make or break your season. Again, we're fortunate enough to come out the way we were playing at that time, 3-3. And then, you know, I can't say we got better in Arizona. I could say maybe we got worse. So going into the Jamestown series, what did we expect out of it? I don't know if we had any expectations, you know, and so coming out with the split against Jamestown was huge for us. I think we came out a different team. We played defense, something we've been griping on them all year about. You know, our pitchers held a team that's hitting 360 as a team. They score a lot of runs. Our pitchers gave us a chance in all four games to win. So, you know, it's kind of again, our conference is so, you know, there's no disparity between the teams this year, and anybody's going to beat anybody. And so, you know, we're right in the middle of the pack, and, you know, we just got to play each game at a time.
What's been the biggest challenge for you with kind of not necessarily having the stalwarts in the lineup that you can count on 1-9? Like you talked about putting people in different positions in Jamestown. What have been the kind of pluses and minuses of that situation from a coaching perspective?
You know, it's tough is because you want kids to get comfortable playing that one mm-hmm. position and that confidence and, okay, you know, maybe I'm the starting third baseman or I'm at shortstop or a second, but the second you have to move somebody to a different position, you know, now they're questioning themselves, and it could be, you know, to benefit the team, but now it's taking away from where they're comfortable playing, but where the team needs them might be somewhere else. So, you know, that's kind of been the toughest, is to get the kids to, you know, believe that they can compete at any position, and they're in that spot for a reason. You know, we've talked a lot as a team to understand your purpose, purpose of why you're in either the five spot or you're playing shortstop this game or second base or some of those things. So, you know, it's, yeah, we talked. Are we young? Yes and no. Is that an excuse? No, but I think just the familiarity with the college softball game. You know, last season when you set a school record of wins, you know, you kind of come in with some pressure. Mm-hmm. And so far we haven't met that pressure and haven't been able to, you know, get to those standards.
In some ways, does a rough start kind of allow you to separate yourself from, you know, chasing a matching last year's level of success, kind of let this team create their own identity moving forward? Do you think there's any?
Yeah, I think it definitely humbled them, you know, brought them back to reality. And, you know, as a coach and a coaching staff, obviously every team's different. You know, one player can change your whole roster, your whole lineup, everything you do. It could change your identity as a team. And, you know, as coaches, we never talk about, you know, the past or what we've done. And I think that the kids just put that pressure on themselves. Instead, and they were so focused on, you know, winning and trying not to lose and trying not to make a mistake, we were just setting ourselves up for failure.
This weekend coming up, rematch of last year's what turned into conference championship series, going three games with Valley. What can folks look forward to in that series?
You know, Valley, they're having a down year themselves. They're not the team they were last year. They lost some big sticks in their lineup. They're struggling trying to find their identity, but you know, they still get runners on base. They run. It's going to be, you know, who's the better team on, I guess, Friday and Saturday. Who's the better team? And you know, if we come out and play the way we played last weekend, we'll have a good chance. You know, and again, our pitchers aren't strikeout pitchers, so they give us a chance. They let batters put the ball in play, and we got to make the plays behind them and, you know, look for those hits when we do get runners on base.
Yeah, and you can come out and check those games. The fields by the high school, I believe, is still where we're playing at.
Yep, North Softball Complex.
There you go. So make sure you come out, coach, any kind of words to get the people out there, get their support for the softball team?
Oh, I think we have a great support from our community and our university and, you know, not only in Dickinson, but across the nation, you know. And, you know, we might not be a team we've been in the past, but the kids are out there, they're working hard, they're giving everything they have out there. And, you know, all we ask them, again, is to get better every day. And so, you know, for softball, you know, our ticket is winning that conference tournament. And fortunately, we get hosted at home. You know, we've been there before. We know what it's like, you know, that feeling. So we're just asking the kids to, you know, get better and get hot when conference tournament time comes.
And Coach Fleury will sign any doctor's note you need to leave work early should that situation present itself. Coach, thanks for joining
thanks
us.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Yeah, we'll be right back with our Blue Feather feature. Welcome back to Hawk Talk. This is our first Blue Feather feature of the episode, and we're joined by one of our softball players. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
My name is Brianna Grayson. I'm from Wilmington, California. I am a senior this year, and I'm a utility player.
Yeah, Brianna, how'd you end up in Dickinson, quite a ways from home?
I honestly just went to a Colorado tournament where a lot of college coaches come and watch players, and I emailed Fleury, and she came and watched me play, and she signed me.
Did the fact that there's quite a few, or have been quite a few California players, that kind of connection there, did that have any influence on your decision to look at Dickinson?
Honestly, I didn't really know anyone before I came. You know, I knew like the coaches were from California, but I didn't really know any of like the players or anything until I came out here.
Yeah. With,
yeah, and you know, California is kind of a hotbed mm-hmm. of softball and that kind of thing. But coming up here, you can't play 12 months out of the year like you can there. How's it been adapting to the kind of seasonal change?
I mean, at first it took a while to get used to, but I mean, I've been out here for 4 years now that I'm kind of gotten used to the weather and practicing inside
making Aberdeen, South Dakota your home in March for a bunch of games.
Exactly. Right in the dome.
Touch on that and the kind of bizarre aspect of playing important conference games mm-hmm. right off the get-go this season with six games that definitely count down the stretch before you've really even been outside.
Mm-hmm. I would say it was a little tough you know, we are a new team this year, and there are a lot of new faces, and I think having to play those three at the beginning was a little tough on, like, team chemistry, but I feel like you just have to go in and just play.
Sure.
You know, the inside was a little tough. I don't like playing on turf, but, yeah. I mean, it's, you know, as long as you get the games in wherever you're playing on the, you know, on wherever it is, you just got to go out and give it your all.
As a utility player, what would you say is your favorite position, and what kind of roles have you grown into that you didn't necessarily think you'd be doing when you got to campus?
I would say my favorite position is a catcher, just because I got signed as a catcher. You know, that's what I do. That's, you know. But starting maybe my sophomore year around, I started playing outfield. She threw me to first. This past Arizona, she threw me at third. You know, so I just, whatever she tells me to do, I just go in and just try to do the best I can at each position she throws me at. Yeah.
With a younger team, or a newer team, not necessarily a younger all the way across the board, but with a lot of new pieces, mm-hmm. What's the most important part of kind of building that chemistry that you talked about might not have been where you needed it that first couple weeks?
Just feel like it's just a lot of more communication with each other on the field, you know, trusting each other, having each other's back, and you just gotta play as a team and not play individually and, you know, stuff like that.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you mentioned you've been here for 4 years mm-hmm. now. What's kind of your leadership role among the team, kind of pushing those younger and newer people?
Especially being a catcher, you know, you have to be, like, that is your priority. Like, this is your field, you know, you see everything more mm-hmm. better than anyone else can, and you have to, you know, you have to be on top of everything, you have to be vocal, you have to pretty much take a role, the whole team.
This last weekend, got to play at home finally, mm-hmm. and this next weekend coming up, home games as well. So how nice is it to not just be at home, but to avoid bus rides for a couple weeks?
Oh, it was very nice not having to sit on a bus for anywhere between 6 and 12 hours. But I'm excited that we're finally home. We have a lot more home games this year.
Definitely.
Conference tournaments at home, so.
Yeah, speaking of that and that kind of being the carrot at the end of the donkey's chasing, so to speak. Where do you see the team progressing and making the strides necessary to kind of put themselves in position to be a player down the stretch?
I think we have it. You know, like, the beginning of the year was a little tough. Arizona was a little tough. But coming out and knowing what we need to do is, that's what we need to do. We need to come out. We need to play together. We need to... can't make little errors, you know.
Sure.
If we're gonna give up runs based off of errors, that's when we need to come back and win that inning and execute with runners, you know, scoring position and
with your time as a softball player coming to a wrap, 4 years in Dickinson, mm-hmm. what's your biggest takeaway from this experience, whether it be on the field, off the field?
Having an opportunity to play in college probably was the biggest one for me. You know, I didn't think I'd make it this far, and Coach Fleury really helped me out a lot by giving me a chance to play for her all 4 years, and I think just being able to play and growing up.
Absolutely.
You know,
awesome. We'll check out the softball team in town this weekend, Saturday and Sunday, and as we kind of foreshadowed, the conference tournament's going to be home in Dickinson as well, so mark your calendars accordingly, and thanks for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Yeah, we'll be back kind of wrapping things up with a baseball player. Welcome to the second portion of our Blue Feather feature today. And we're joined by the other Diamond Sports, baseball. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Sean Getchell. I'm a left-handed pitcher for the Hawks, exercise science major. I was born in Billings, Montana.
Yeah, and you kind of came up through college playing in Miles City. We've had quite a few kids coming over from that direction, so kind of touch on what it's like to play with some of your old teammates from out in Montana.
You know, it's actually been really nice. Like, I know our catcher, Chad Mackey, he went to junior college with me, so that was really nice having him come over as well.
Yeah, and especially for those two positions, you know, working together a lot, I'm sure that helped out with kind of the chemistry moving into the year. You opened up the spring season playing in U.S. Bank Stadium, the home of the Minnesota Vikings. How cool was it to walk out on the field there?
Oh, it was so cool. Like, it was just, I mean, just all the stadium seats, and, like, it was just so big. It echoed like crazy.
Yeah, and you followed up playing before you played the University of Minnesota, played the University of Hawaii. How interesting was it to see kind of that higher level of baseball?
You know, it was really fun to watch. Like, those guys are just so talented. Like, they just throw the ball across, and it was just fast. It was a lot faster pace.
Trip down to Arizona after that to kind of continue with the cool opportunities playing for the Blue Hawks. And that trip ended on a pretty solid note. So touch on what the team kind of went through down in Arizona and being able to wrap that up with a winning record on that trip.
Well, I mean, we just kind of, we played as a team well. We pitched when we needed to pitch, hit when we needed to hit. And I just thought we did really good compared to last year even.
Getting in the end of things with conference action, starting off at presentation, you kind of ended up as we just had a utility player on. You're kind of a utility arm, so to speak, being used in different roles to help the team where they needed. So touch on the different roles you played that weekend and how you're how you've ended up in that position where you kind of do it all.
I mean, I don't know. Like, it's just it's kind of different. Being like a closing guy and like a starting guy.
Yeah.
Just kind of whenever coach needs me to go in, I'm just going to go in and hopefully do my best.
Is there a mindset adjustment to knowing, you know, you got a guy who starts game two every weekend and you kind of have that mindset? Did you have to make an adjustment to be able to kind of succeed in that role where you never know when coach is going to look at you? And...
Oh, yeah. Like, it is a lot more stressful coming into games. Oh, man.
A little more respect for the bullpen after.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Definitely.
With this last weekend, you got the opportunity to be a part of something that hasn't happened since 2013, I believe, a 1-0 shutout win. Just touch on that performance and getting it done from start to finish. That time it was as a starter.
Yeah, it was definitely, it was a career day for me. I don't know, it was just kind of a good day, really good day. Defensively, we played well. I pitched, just did well.
The interesting bit of a rivalry there with Jamestown. So coming out with that split and leaving yourselves at 6-2 in conference, how much do you kind of see the big picture of conference play and knowing how important each win is?
I don't know.
Just one game at a time is your guys' philosophy, so to speak?
Yeah, definitely.
Coming from Miles City, what was the biggest transition from that level to this level, would you say?
I'm kind of freezing up.
No, you're fine.
Biggest transition, I would say, just kind of the competition level is a little bit different. You know, like, we get to see a lot better hitters, I feel like, on this level than we would in junior colleges. And then, like, the amount of traveling is a lot crazier here.
You've gotten to be at home mm-hmm. once this year,
yeah.
And you'll get that opportunity again. Is that a nice break from missing classes and from being on the bus?
It is very nice, especially for some of my classes like chemistry. That one's really hard to miss.
I believe it.
Yeah, so looking forward, you know, have a couple home stands coming up. Just kind of give the people out there watching a reason to come out and watch the Blue Hawks.
You know, I think we're going to do really good this weekend against Valley City. It's a really important games for us because, like, they're tied for second, just like we are with Jamestown and can't remember who else
Mayville.
Is in there. Mayville. Yeah, Mayville. So if we come out 4-0 this weekend, we've got a really good chance of taking the conference.
and you never know. He might know when he's pitching, but we're not going to disclose that in case that arrangement has been made. You never know when Sean will be on the mound. He might be on the mound all four games. He's flexible out there. But Sean, what's been your biggest takeaway from the opportunity to come and continue your baseball career here?
Oh man, just to play college and baseball another 2 years. Like, I love playing baseball, and like getting a little scholarship money was really nice to come and do what I love.
Absolutely. Check out Sean and his team. We've been told Friday will be the start of the baseball and softball series. So make that adjustment. Friday at 11, is that,
yep,
is that what you've
Friday
been told? All right, no reason to show up to work after lunch. Just come on out to the ballpark. Thanks for joining us, Sean.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Thanks, Sean. Yeah, we'll catch up with some golf folks next week, as well as track, hopefully. So until then, Hawks are up.